Say hello to Traveler-san. Through the creative use of game mechanics, and at times glitches, we're on a quest to see just how much of Genshin Impact can be completed using only the Traveler. And we sometimes break things. If you enjoyed the series, do make sure to like and subscribe. It helps Traveler-san out a lot. Ah, Tatara Tales. What a quest. As of this video's publication, still 4 days of it to go. This quest taught me that 1. The Fatui are some of the toughest enemies for Traveler-san. 2. Bale Thunder is the worst thing ever without Barbara. And 3. This cannon slaps. Except, it's like they purposely put a loading zone in front of said cannon, preventing you from shooting enemies with it. I can blast this group of samurai near this cannon, but that group farther away? Look at this. Seriously, one step past the interact range of the cannon, and they drop out of draw distance. It's the same for the northern cannon, too. What a load of crap. But Tatara Tales isn't what anyone wants to see. As such, it's time for Traveler-san to flex a bit of muscle and take down his first world boss. Because of all the work that went towards breaking into Inazuma, it rightfully has to be an Inazuma boss. The poll results have spoken. With more votes than every other boss combined, Golden Wolf Lord it is. But let's make this more interesting by setting a limitation. No healing with food. Traveler-san is going to channel his inner Adol. Just a dude with a sword, a big monster, and a fierce battle until only one is left standing. Am I going to regret this? Maybe. Will this apply to future bosses? Who knows? Enough delay. It's time to get in there and fight. Honestly, not as difficult as one might expect. Certainly, this wasn't a one-and-done challenge, but all in all, it only took about half an hour to get a win. As with any boss, it was a matter of learning the patterns, keeping my guard up, and waiting for an opportunity to counterattack. There were a few things that gave me trouble. First, the projectile attack that launches those gold wolf faces. Starfell's sword can be used as a shield against them, but the third projectile tends to come straight down, and can cause damage. I started to evade them, rather than rely on a shield that may not block the third. Second, corrosion. It's not too terrible, but it does make it so that there's no last chance should the initial attack leave Traveler-san with health remaining. A little aside here, when this situation would arise, I'd just teleport away to a Statue of the Seven. And this happened one of the times. If you've ever wondered what happened if your party got wiped out while a statue was healing them, wonder no more. The biggest obstacle of all, however, was the Golden Wolf Lord's ramming attack. The hitbox is huge, and it can combo. I thought maybe it could be jumped over with Starfell Sword, but that didn't work, and on the contrary, only made things worse. I eventually got the hang of evading it, which requires standing near the opposite end of the arena and running perpendicular to the boss the moment it signaled the attack was coming. And thus, the first world boss has been checked off the list. Okay, time to return to exploring Inazuma. Truthfully, Traveler-san's time in this land is nearing its end. But before returning to Mondstadt and Liyue, there are some more quests to do, more treasures to find, another constellation to earn, and a few strange occurrences to share. Let's begin with one of those occurrences, and just call it like it is. How I deleted a key from the game without ever obtaining the key. Seirai Island, a place most unlike anywhere else in Genshin Impact. Not only because of its murderous electro field and targeted lightning, but because of the terrain itself. A lot of times in Genshin Impact, you'll see a spot that looks like you should be able to drop down or walk into it. Yet, instead of that, there will be an invisible wall blocking the path. And not so with this place. What you see is what you get. Whoever designed this place did so with extreme care to match the terrain's model with its collision. So if you see a hole or something on this island, chances are incredibly high that you can crawl into it. Case, point, and stage, the Seirai Maru. There are two ways to easily enter this ship without completing the puzzle. The first, drop down into the cavern, glide over to this mess of wood, and climb through to get inside. This leads to the lower hull of the ship. The second, just go through the side door as one normally would after completing the puzzle. No, seriously, just walk up and go through. This, of course, leads to the upper hull, and one can travel between the two by dropping down or climbing up this small hole. We begin on the lower portion. The tile puzzle doesn't work if one breaks in, so those locked chests can't be opened. This common chest can be, though. And look at that loot. Moving to the upper section, the Sealy can be followed around. And this is kind of funny. Why open doors again? Just have to approach them, and the little fellow will continue on their way. The rotating puzzle can be completed through the floor. Sounds like more unused keys to add to the collection. And like the puzzle, the chest can be looted. Although looting the chest in this manner is incredibly precise. Huh. Weird. Wasn't this chest supposed to give a key? You know, the intact key. For the door on the lower portion? Is it in one of the treasure chests locked behind the puzzle? Hold on, let me check a guide. Okay, I see. Yep. Well, that key's gone forever. Remember that common chest? This is supposed to be what gives the intact key. As shown here on the loot obtained, no key. Perhaps it was a one-time fluke, and something glitched. I knew how to break into this ship because I'd done it on my main account long ago. So I went to check that account's inventory. Oh, there's the key. I also repeated the process on another account, and what the heck, the key is there. Either it's a fluke for Traveler-san, or it's tied to having broken into Inazuma. Dang it. And here I was about to urge you all to tell your new friends in-game that you have a cool glitch to show them. Help them break into here, and instruct them to open the common chest. It'd just be a harmless little prank. Anyways, surely you didn't think not having a key would stop me, because I did end up completing Seirai Maru. And that's because of the whole thing I mentioned earlier with the terrain of Seirai Island. See that hole near the doorframe? With great difficulty, one can climb through it. No key, no problem. Seirai Island is amazing. As one may guess, traversing within the Bale Thunder of Seirai Island? Well, it's been established already how bad it was at Tatarasuna. Now add in rapid fire, accurate lightning strikes like those of the storm we fought while breaking into Inazuma, and crank their damage up tenfold. Oh boy, that's a dead Traveler-san. Just another on the tally I've lost track of since beginning to collect Electroculus within the Bale Thunder. Boy, do I miss Barbara. She can nearly survive forever in here, and that makes exploration so, so easy. It was around this time that I had the genius idea to level up the Sacred Sakura's favor. After all, boosting that makes Electrogranna last longer and block more Bale Thunder damage. Oh, I can't access the Sacred Sakura tree. Well, back to enduring torture. There's another Electroculus. Might as well nab this puzzle while I'm here with Electro. And there's another Fallen Traveler, son. Oh, wait, nice. Never mind. So if it weren't apparent, much like everywhere else on Inazuma, no quests are available here. Even the Cat Shrine is missing its quests. Hello, cats. I shall leave your little rock slide hideout intact, and be on my way. While there's still one thing to tackle on Seirai Island, for now, let's move on. From one stormy island to another, Yashiori Island. Though I've already gathered the Electroculus here, as part of the montage in episode 3, I'm here to obtain something else. Namely, gathering the orbs and wards for Orobashi's legacy. By now, it likely comes as no surprise when I say the quest is inaccessible. What's strange about it, though, is that Kaji is on the island. When spoken to, he inquires about the status of repairing the wards, as if the quest has been started. Still, the wards can't be repaired, and I'm here simply to retrieve the items for a future experiment involving this quest. Look at those guys trying to get in here. Sorry, pals, you had this place so heavily guarded that I figured I'd just go under the barrier. Whoa, that was pretty close. This jump is hard. Worried that if I go up any farther, I'll get pulled out by the barrier. There we go, the first of two. Why not first of three? I'm deeming one of these impossible to get without Shao. Let me quickly explain. This one right here. The area on screen is a nightmare to navigate while out of bounds, and trying to reach the center of that barrier from below the map is even more of a nightmare. I managed to do so on my main account, but without Shao, it may have been impossible. All the climbable terrain barely extends below the map, and there are hardly any areas safe from the pool of the water above. The path to reach it was long, and the precision needed to keep Shao below some of the incredibly thin pieces of rock was akin to threading a needle. So yeah, this orb will be nabbed later on, when the quest is available. Okay, that's two orbs and two wards. For the third ward, let's go diving, shall we? I mean, it is underwater in this cavern. A cavern whose secret exit is, guarded by a gate that's not guarding anything at all. Although I suppose dropping down there doesn't amount to much. But you know what does amount to much? How about the fact that this little gate has the power to temporarily dispel the curse on Yashiori Island? Look at this. One moment it's dark and stormy, and the next, after stepping onto this gate, bright and sunny. I thought, okay, so this probably happens with any cavern on the island. Nope. From what I can tell, it's exclusive to this one. I digress, though. Let's go diving. And there we are, down below the water. Finish the puzzle, open the chest. Oh, that's right. When a treasure chest is opened underwater, its contents teleport to the surface. We'll come back for that. Nice bubble you have there, slime. Yeah, a Hydro Slime's bubbles just float in place if used underwater. Ah, yes. Swimming in water. Underwater. Anyways, there's the last ward. Now to just carefully climb up and out of here. With these quest items gathered, it's time to move on to some of the remaining Electroculus. These are the troubling Electroculus. The easy ones have been gathered, and those that remain are supposed to be locked behind inaccessible quests or high-level thunder barriers that can't be phased through with level 1 Electrogranna. First up, the Electroculus locked behind Relics of Seirai. Boom. Easy. As mentioned, the collision of Seirai Island's terrain conforms to its model, so a hole in the floor above can be dropped through to get into the basement. Much like the tile puzzle of Seirai Maru, it can't be activated. Same with the lever on the wall. Next, the Electroculus in Araumi. This one is underwater and behind a mid-level thunder barrier. So, Electrogranum can't be used here. After draining the water, it's a matter of navigating out of bounds to the location. Pretty neat out here. And the water that used to fill those ruins is now a giant disc below the map. The ruins don't load in till we're close, and the line can be walked to see them load and unload. So anyways, just drop, glide in from the side, and let the tiny bit of water still present in the ruins work its magic. For now, that's a wrap. Extracting these last few Electroculus will take some time, and hopefully we'll be finished by the next episode, which is planned to be the finale of the No Archon Quest Inazuma arc. Traveler-san will be braving the toughest location in the game, obtaining the final 8 Electroculus to unlock Constellation 4 Electro, and battling the true final boss. As always, if you're finding that you enjoy the series, a like, subscribe, even a share helps tremendously. I also sometimes share tidbits on my Twitter at Musashiden if you're interested in following. This is Musashi and Traveler-san, signing off. Till next time!